नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ JVN ब्रिजेश कुमार यादव, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। आई वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन माई डिजिटल क्लास। स्टूडेंट्स, आई हैव प्रिपेयर्ड दिस लेक्चर फॉर BSc BEd ZBC 6M। सब्जेक्ट नेम इज़ प्लांट फिजियोलॉजी। स्टूडेंट्स, ऑन प्रीवियस टर्न वी वेयर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट the mineral and their uptake. So far we have seen that how these minerals are important for plants and how they get absorbed by plants. Okay, now today we are going to see some of the aspects related to their deficiency. Suppose in the lack of that particular nutrients, what will be the symptoms, what will be problems, what will be their hindrance in the plants. Okay, I have tried to make them in tabular form and I am presenting over here that these are the elements and respective to them their deficiency symptoms, what kind of symptoms appeared in the plants in the deficiency of particular nutrients. Okay, so let's start with nitrogen. You all know that we have already explained that nitrogen is one of the important component of proteins, amino acids. So it plays crucial role in vital activity of plants. In the absence of this nutrient nitrogen, plants showed these are the some symptoms such as stunted growth, pale green, yellow or brown leaves, slender stem, anthocyanin accumulation. This anthocyanin is a kind of pigment which accumulation increased in the plants, that indicates that there is a deficiency of nitrogen in that plants. Okay, so these are some of the symptoms of the deficiency of nitrogen. For potassium, plants showed mottled or chlorotic leaves, that is faded green or yellow, with dead spots, that is necrosis. Even it shows curling or crinkling. Okay, so these are the symptoms of deficiency of potassium in plants. Now phosphorus, you all know that phosphorus is one of the important component of many enzymes, amino acids and proteins. In the deficiency of phosphorus, plants show stunted growth, dark green leaves with dead spots, that is necrosis. Some anthocyanin accumulation is also present in the deficiency of phosphorus. Magnesium, in the deficiency of magnesium, plant shows mottled or chlorotic leaves, especially in interveinal zone, tips and edges of leaves curled upward curling, that is. Next, calcium is also important component of middle lamella, we all know. Okay, so in the absence of in the deficiency of calcium, plant so these are the symptoms such as young leaves at the bud hooked, that is inward curling, then die back at edges, stalk dies at bud. Boron is also important component for cell plate middle lamella. In the deficiency of boron, plant showed young leaves of the terminal bud get light green, leaves twisted, stalk die at bud. Sulfur, in the deficiency of sulfur, plant showed symptoms such as chlorosis, young leaves light green, some anthocyanin accumulation is there. For iron, in the absence of iron, young leaves get chlorotic, especially in intervenal zones. Copper symptoms are young leaves, wilted terminal bud, dark green leaves, necrosis. Next, manganese. In the deficiency of manganese, plant showed the symptoms of chlorosis and necrosis. For zinc, plant showed rosette growth, leaves small, puckered, that is cup set, also showed less oxygen. For molybdenum, it is intervenal necrosis, poor flowering. It also can be nitrogen deficiency. And for chlorine, wilting at leaf tips, general necrosis and chlorosis, bronzing and stunted growth of plants. So students, in this way we have seen the deficiency symptom of particular minerals in the plants. Thank you very much.